Good evening, Baldwin. Good to see you. Welcome to the Baldwin High School winter presentation of our band program. Tonight's first band is going to be the Baldwin High School Concert Band under the direction of Miss Deanna Nykirk. We're really excited to have an audience. It was really important to the staff, to the teachers and I, to make sure that our students had a live audience and heard applause. For some of them, it's been a few years since they actually performed live in front of anyone. So we really wanted to make that happen, and we're glad today you're here. So this means a lot to us and to our students. We will be videotaping tonight's program, and it will be available on a YouTube channel, which the teachers will share with you so you can access it later, or share it with friends and family. With that, I'd like to ask one of our students, Sanaa Cadet, to come forward. She is going to lead us in the national anthem. Please rise. Please be seated. Tonight we're joined by our building principal, Dr. Testa's here. This is a good time of year to be a principal. It's a busy time, but there's a vacation coming. So I'm sure he's looking forward to it as much as our students and I as well. With that, I'm going to turn the program over to Ms. Nykirk, and she will be leading our students through a wonderful concert. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody. typically, I just walk out onto the stage and get on the podium, and we have at it after the intro, but I do want to take a moment just to explain what we're doing here for our first piece. So we're going to bring a little bit of the holiday spirit into our program. We decided that our full concert band program was just missing that one aspect. So these students wanted to put something together for you just so that we could kick off our program with a little bit of that holiday spirit. So this is what we've been referring to as our mini-band, and we are going to play a carol for you. And our student will come up to introduce that to you right now. So So this is Mr. William Zelaya coming up to introduce the first Noah.
The first Noel is a traditional English carol with roots from the 15th century. Noel is a French word for Christmas and is from the Latin Natalis, meaning birthday. Like other carols, it was passed on through oral tradition until its first publication in Gilbert's Some Ancient Christmas Carols in 1823. He took it from a manuscript of Cornish carols made around 1817. And are available today in the county record office in Truro, England.
Regular concert band seats now while the rest of the ensemble joins us. So we'll just be a minute and then we'll get the rest of the program started. Now we have Darlene coming up to introduce the chorale suite.
Good evening, family and friends. The chorale suite is a three-movement work by James Swearing. The first and third movement were written by Lauren Mason and W.H. Monk, respectfully, and were arranged by James Swearin. The second movement was written by James Swearin himself. The chorale suite taught us about communication throughout the band. This is a piece we work very hard on, and we hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
last but not least, Sue Lava is going to come up to introduce our last piece, which is called Gotta Make Noise.
To be quiet is to be polite, and to be noisy is to be untamed. That's most people's take on it anyway. However, there are people who think that to be quiet is to exist, and to be noisy is to be present. Michael Kohlgrass is one of them. No more Beethoven, no more Mozart, no more drums being shoved all the way back in the stage. No more no. To negate is to preach silence and conformity. Well, we do not want silence and we do not conform. What we can do, however, is shout. Shout like we do on the phone with our friends at all hours of the night, regardless of how annoying you may find us. Now, this isn't your typical introduction to a piece of music, because this isn't your typical piece of music. Fitting, isn't it? No, this is the kind of music that's full of life and difference, and honestly, it's just really fun. And that's good, because that's how music should be. This is how music should be, because to be quiet is to be polite, but to be noisy is to be present. So I mean it in the nicest way possible when I say, this is called Gotta Make Noise.
you all so much for being here tonight. It means so much to me and, of course, to our students up here on the stage to have an audience to play for. I wish you all happy holidays. I'll see you throughout the, well, I'll see you next time, since we're going to have another concert coming up soon. But happy holidays, everybody. Thank you again. Thank you to for all the support from our administrators and everybody that was here to help make this happen tonight. So it's been a while, and I think we all appreciate it so much. So thanks again, everybody. Have a good night. Have a happy holiday.
One more time for the Baldwin High School Concert Choir, please. With that, we wish you all a happy holiday and a wonderful new year. See you next year. You can meet your children out in the courtyard. Another group of parents will be coming in shortly. Thank you and have a wonderful evening. Good evening, Baldwin. So good to see all of you. We're so happy that our concert is happening tonight and we're able to get it in. And we have such a wonderful audience of their family members and friends. We really look forward to the day where we can have multiple bands and orchestras and choruses on the same stage. But until then, this is fine. A small crowd is nice. You get to see and hear everything. Welcome. Tonight you're in for a treat. Our symphony band has been busy since day one, working very hard. Mr. Dunn and Ms. Nykirk have been really hard at work, really energetic at bringing this moment, making this moment happen. So I'm not going to talk too much longer. I'm going to introduce our concert master. She's going to tune our band. It's Lindsay Harris. Correction. I too am out of practice. We haven't done this enough, apparently. Please rise for the national anthem. It will be played by Sanaa Cadet. Please be seated. And now please welcome Lindsay Harris, concertmaster. Please welcome to the stage Ms. Deanna Nykirk, conductor of the symphony band, along with Mr. Dunn, who happens to be playing at the moment.
My name is Lindsay Harris, and I'm a senior clarinet player in the symphony band. In 1959, Charles Carter wrote his best and most often performed piece, his Overture for Winds. Born in Oklahoma in 1926, he was educated at Ohio State and Eastman, and taught for 43 years at Florida State University. He is one of the first American composers to commit his talents to writing educational band music. The performers must execute tempo, dynamic, and articulation changes without giving away abrupt shifts to the audience. For the audience, the piece can seem like a roller coaster ride of changes, shifting between fast and slow, yet seamlessly regaining strength and driving toward a brilliant close. Mr. Carter has created a masterpiece of academic and entertainment value. We hope you enjoy our performance.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. My name is Jose Cibrian, and I am a senior alto saxophone player in symphony band. All of you will no doubt recognize the old Scottish melody as the famous song Auld Lang Syne. Auld Lang Syne translates literally to Auld Lang Since, Auld Long Since, or more loosely to Days Gone By. This beautiful poem written by Robert Burns in 1788 is used across the world to remember the days of yore. In Chile, they sing it at funerals, in Hungary at graduations, and here in the United States at New Year's. This beautiful setting for band was masterfully done by Charles Wiley. This, like the Carter Overture, is a staple of the band repertoire, and we hope you enjoy. Happy holidays and a very happy, healthy New Year.
Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for being here. It's great to have a live audience. It's great to see all of you, and we appreciate the opportunity to make music for you. Before I invite Samari up to talk about the last tune, I'd like to thank a couple people on the stage first. You see the not student in the back who's so tall and strappingly good looking. That's our BOCES percussion artist. His name is Jim Dragovich. Please give a big thank you, warm round of applause. Mr. Dragovich is the retired band director from Hewlett High School. He comes every Wednesday to work with our percussionists, and he's a tremendous asset to our program. And so if you saw the show, he was also the drummer in the pit for the show. So he is an indispensable part of our program. So thank you, Mr. Byers. Mr. Dragovich. Next is Scott Byers, who some of you might recognize. Stand up, Mr. Byers. this very tall, good-looking fellow. Yes, Scott Byers is the band director at Merrick Avenue Middle School in Merrick. He student-taught here 4 years ago, so the seniors remember him when they were freshmen, and he's a terrific musician and band director, and we have a lot of saxophones absent tonight, so he's playing in all three bands. So thank you, Mr. Byers. And to our flute, yes, thank you. When we arrived to symphony band rehearsal this morning, the entire front row of flutes was missing. All of them. So you'll notice the front row of flute players, neither one are current students here at Baldwin High School. One is a graduate of the class of 2019. She's a flute major at LIU Post. She's going to be a terrific educator someday. Please help me in thanking Anne Jean-Baptiste, who's playing flute. Thank you, Anne. And the other flutist doubling as conductor tonight is my colleague, Deanna Nyberg. So, she is not a flutist, she is a clarinetist who plays saxophone and occasionally flute, and was strong-armed into doing this, so I appreciate this very much. So the last tune we're gonna do, I'll let Samari explain to you. It's fun, don't hold me accountable for art music, but we're gonna have a good time. So anyway, thank you all for being here. Happy holidays to you, and here comes Samari Walston.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Samari Walston, and I am a junior flute player in the symphony band. Our final selection tonight is both fun to listen to and fun to play. And even though Mr. Dunn hates programming this kind of thing on a serious concert, this piece is an exception. As we welcome all of you back to our concert hall for the first time in 2 years, we feel you deserve to leave here whistling and tapping. This also happens to be a terrific and very musical arrangement. Larry Clark has taken the grooves from well-known jazz music, pieces some you will recognize like Glenn Miller's In the Mood, Little Brown Jug, and Pennsylvania 5000. Benny Goodman's famous Sing, 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 and Dave Brubeck's Take Five. But instead of the original jazz melodies, Mr. Clark uses these melodies of well-known Christmas carols over these swinging grooves. We took time to learn these classic jazz tunes during rehearsals and have the best and had a blast working this piece in rehearsals. From all of us in the Baldwin High School Symphony Band, we appreciate you being here tonight and wish you the happiest of holiday seasons. Thank you.
Thank you.
One more time for the Baldwin Symphony Band. So glad we could get that big sound in front of an audience. With that, we wish you all the best in your holiday season. We wish you a happy new year, and hopefully have a wonderful evening and a nice dinner. Thank you, students. See you outside. We have another family, group of families coming in for the next concert. Thank you, and have a great night. Good evening, Baldwin.
Good evening.
So good to see each of you. This is a big day for our students to perform before a live audience. We worked really hard to get to this moment, and so we wanted to make sure we did whatever we could to make sure our students and you guys could see your children do their thing. They sound amazing. Our staff, students have really worked hard, and we're looking forward to finishing out this year as smooth as possible and heading to 2022. With that, I'd like to ask you to stand, and I'm gonna invite Sanaa Cadet to the stage. She's going to perform the national anthem. Please be seated. Thank you, Sanaa. We're joined this evening by our building principal, Dr. Testa, in the back. Thank you for supporting everything we do, Dr. Testa. And I also want to acknowledge Mr. Lloyd Means up there in the balcony. He's videotaping our program today. And we'll share the links with your children so that you can see it later if you wish, or share it with others. And with that, I'm going to turn the program over to our Wind Symphony. And first, I'm going to introduce our concertmaster, Amalia Tavares. present to you the Wind Symphony Band under the direction of Mr. Scott Dunn.
Good evening, everybody. Thank you very much. You can sit down. Thank you very much for being here. It means a lot to us, and we're going to play some great music for you. Before we begin, I just want to say a couple of thank yous and shout outs. A lot went into tonight, and a lot happened before tonight, as I think you all know. So the fact that we're all sitting here, I think, is just a grand achievement. But I was at the choir concert on Thursday night, and I'll tell you a secret. It was really good. And sadly, I missed the orchestra concert last Monday because my daughter was sick, but I'm sure that was really good too. And I think the initial goal of all of this when we first decided to give public concerts was just to get out there and play. That was the achievement. And then I heard the choir concert, and I realized there was a lot more at stake. The artistic standards are very high here. They remain very high. And although coming back this year didn't feel normal or didn't feel like 2 years ago, this band has had a great last month of rehearsal. And the product you will see tonight is very different than the product you saw on October 14th when we played at the fall concert, if you were there. So I'm very proud of the work that they've done. I'm very proud of the repertoire that we're playing. And I think we're on a trajectory that's going to bring us back to where we were pre-pandemic. So I want to thank them for the hard work that they've put in. And I think you're in for a real treat. I want to thank Mr. Paprillo for all his work, both here tonight and behind the scenes. And to Dr. Testa, who's always here at everything, thank you. I don't know if you're here right now, Dr. Testa, but thank you for everything. Yes, today and always. Your leadership is tremendous, and we can't thank you enough. My colleagues, Ms. Nykirk, Mrs. Muir, Mrs. Costello, it's a difficult time, as you know, to do what we do, but coming to work every day is a joy. So I appreciate that. To the very tall and strappingly good-looking man in the back, Mr. Jim Dragovich. He's obviously not a high school student. He's our BOCES percussion artist. He comes every Wednesday to work the percussionist. And in the absence of many of our students tonight, he's here covering a lot of parts. So thank you, Mr. Dragovich. To my dear friend Scott Byers, who's sitting here with a baritone saxophone in his hand. He played tenor sax in the last band, bari sax in the first band. And the seniors remember him when he student taught here 3 years ago when they were freshmen. He's been the band director at Merrick Avenue Middle School for 3 years. He's the graduate conducting assistant at Montclair State University. He's a tremendous musician, saxophonist, and conductor, and a dear friend of mine and somebody I trust in this profession, which is, says a lot. And so anyway, thank you, Mr. Byers, for being here tonight and playing with us. Yes, yes. And to the best second flutist we could ever ask for, she's not even a flutist, she's a clarinetist and sometimes a saxophonist, and we had to arm her into playing flute tonight when both of our second flutists went down for the count. So anyway, please a round of applause for Ms. Nykirk. And when we walked out of this building March 13th of 2020 for a couple days just to regroup, we were in the middle of Percy Grainger's music. And so it's very fitting for us to come back tonight and play you Percy Grainger's music, which pairs so well with this Mackie Sheltering Sky, and then a little fun sleigh ride at the end. You'll be out of here in like 12 minutes, I promise. So without further ado, Percy Grainger, John Mackie, and Leroy Anderson, and Dennis Thomas will come to tell you a little bit about the Grainger before we start. Thank you, everybody. Happy holidays, okay?
Setting is dedicated to the memory of Percy Aldrich Grainger, whom I wish I had known, in gratefulness that he loved the sounds of wind instruments and that he created such beautiful music for them. With this publication, we hope to bring to light one of Grainger's many attractive, though neglected, compositions. Grainger's recognition and acclaim rests upon a very small measure of his life's accomplishments. It saddened him that so many of his works were seldom, if ever, performed. He wrote, "The bulk of these works are not alive, for music that is not heard is not alive. And the bulk of my music is never heard." In the making of this setting, we have faithfully preserved the voicing and harmonies of the original, and have done our best to recreate Grainger's scoring for wind choirs. We hope you enjoy our performance of Percy Grainger's Green Bushes.
Thank you. Granger played the saxophone and Granger loved the saxophone, and I think it's fitting that Dennis gave that little speech.
Has in the 21st century a host of disparate styles that dominate its texture. At the core of its contemporary development exists a group of composers who dazzle with scintillating and frightening virtuosity. As such, at first listening, one might experience Don Mackey's Sheltering Sky as a striking departure, Its serene and simple presentation is a throwback of sorts, a nostalgic portrait of time suspended. The work itself has a folk song-like quality, intended by the composer, and through this, an immediate sense of familiarity emerges. Certainly, the repertoire has a long and proud tradition of weaving folk songs into its identity, from the days of Holtz and Vaughan Williams to modern treatments by such figures as Donald Grantham and Frank DeKelly. Whereas these composers incorporated extant melodies into their works, however, Mackie takes a play from Percy Grainger. Grainger's colonial song seemingly sets a beautiful folk song melody in an enchanting way, so enchanting, in fact, that he reworked the tune into two other pieces, Australian Upcountry Tune and The Gumsucker's March. In reality, however, Grainger's melody was entirely original, his own concoction to express how he felt about his native Australia. Likewise, although the melodies of Sheltering Sky have a recognizable quality, as hints of the contours and colors of Danny Boy and Shenandoah are perceptible, the tunes themselves are original to the work, imparting a sense of hazy distance as though they were from a half-remembered dream.
Thank you.
One more time for the Wind Symphony, please. Thank all of our music teachers for coming out and supporting. Even though it wasn't their night, they're always here to help out and be a part of the team. Wishing you all a wonderful holiday season and a happy new year. Have a wonderful evening. Thank you so much for coming.